In this tutorial, we will focus specifically on the Tools menu options in the Diagram screen. The Clear Diagram button will completely remove all objects from the diagram. To see this work, we will need to first either create or import a diagram or load a template. We will select the PCS or Process Control System option. To remove all objects in the diagram, simply click the button. Always remember that when you change the diagram by either clearing, importing, or by loading, all the associated data is lost. This means that any component answers, comments, and files associated with those questions are also lost. We recommend saving your assessment to a backup file before proceeding. The Import Diagram button allows you to import or read in a diagram that was created outside of this immediate assessment. It could be from someone within your organization or from some external source like a trade association, consultant, or vendor. It could also be from a previous version of CSET. To import a file, click the Import Diagram button. This will bring up a selection window where you can locate and select the file. The only file types that import recognizes are .csetd, which is a version 5 or greater diagram-only file, .csset, which is a version 5 or greater full assessment file, .ogxml, which is a diagram-only version of previous CSET releases, and .orxml, which are full assessment files also from previous releases. When a diagram is imported from a previous release, it does not import the assessment or any associated answers or other information. When you click the Open button, the file is imported into the assessment. As mentioned earlier, the existing diagram will be completely replaced and any answers will be lost. The Export Diagram button allows you to save the diagram to an external file. It creates a file with the extension .csetd. This can be shared or saved as a backup. It does not save associated answers. The Manage Templates button opens a form that allows you to control what diagram templates are available in the assessment. This can be especially useful for large organizations with multiple similar divisions. For example, I may want to distribute a copy of a blank assessment with only two templates available. The first is a predefined template called Oil and Gas 2, and the second is a new one called Acme Base. First, we will clear all the checks under the Heading Display template, except for the one assigned to Oil and Gas 2. We do this by double-clicking on the box to uncheck it. Now we will add the new template. In the Template Name field, we will enter Acme Base, and then click the Add Template button. We then select the diagram file from the list and click on the Open button to load the template. You can see that it is automatically checked for display. Click OK to finish and close this form. When we first started the tutorial, we used the Load Template option to bring in a diagram. We now click on the button and see only the two options that were set in the Manage Templates form. We can click either one to load that template. We'll now turn our attention to layers. If you've used layers in other diagramming tools, then the concept should be familiar to you. To add layers, click on the Manage Layers button to open the respective form. The process is simple. Type in the new layer name and then click the Add Layer button. In this tutorial, we will add several new layers. They are Corporate, Building 101, and Area 51. Press the OK button to save the new layers and close the form. After the layers have been defined, objects such as devices, zones, text, and connectors can be assigned to a layer. There are two ways to go about this. The first is to click on an object and change the layer property. We will assign the VPN in the Plant Control Center zone to the Building 101 layer. To select multiple objects, make sure the selector button is on. Go to the diagram menu and click on the selector button if it is not already on. Now click on a corner of the screen and draw a box around the corporate zone. You will see indicator boxes around all the objects enclosed in the frame. In the Properties window, change the layer to Corporate. There are two ways to turn layer visibility on and off. The first is to use the Layers button. This will open a form with checkboxes where unchecking a box will turn a layer off, and clicking the checkbox will turn a layer on. The second way to change the visibility of layers is through the Manage Layers form. Open this again and uncheck the Building 101 layer. Notice that the VPN that was assigned to that layer is no longer visible. The next button we will discuss is the Analyze Network button that is on by default. Clicking this will turn on or off basic network analysis. Let's demonstrate. First, we will remove the firewall between the web and the corporate networks and then draw in its place a connecting line. You will notice the numbered red icons that appear showing that there is something wrong. When you click on the icon, a message box will be displayed, giving clues as to why this situation was flagged. When you click on the Analyze Network button to turn it off, the application will no longer display the network warnings icons. The next option in the Tools menu is the Print button. Clicking this button on will open a standard print form that allows you to select a printer and either print or plot the diagram, depending on the available equipment. The final option is the Inventory button, which, when clicked, creates an inventory list of the components included in the diagram and their relevant information. The list opens as a Microsoft Excel spreadsheet. It can be saved and will be available for inclusion in the Security Plan printed report. This concludes this tutorial. See other specific tutorials for more discussion on using diagram functions.